हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक दैट इज़ नैनो पार्टिकल्स। इट इज़ इन द क्लास द नोवेल रेगुलेटरी सिस्टम और स्पेसिफिक फॉर द टारगेटेड रेगुलेटरी सिस्टम दैट वी हैव टू कंसीडर दैट नैनो पार्टिकल्स। प्रीवियसली वी हैव टू सी इन द टारगेटेड रेगुलेटरी सिस्टम द ड्रग कैरियर लाइक लिपोसोम, नियोसोम। सिमिलर लाइक टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक दैट इज नैनो पार्टिकल्स। First of all, in the introductions, that we have to see the definition parts of the nanoparticles. So the nanoparticles, so it derived from the Greek words that is nano, that is means the extremely small size particle. That is term we can call the nanoparticles. So nanoparticles are defined as a sub nano size colloidal structures or colloidal regulatory system. That is composed of synthetic or semi-synthetic polymers that is carrying the drug or the proteinaceous substance like antigen. The particle size of the nanoparticles, it ranges between from the 10 to 1000 nanometer in the diameter. So in that, the drugs are dissolved, entrapped or encapsulated into the polymer matrix, particularly or the solid solutions, or maybe bound particle surface by physical adsorption or any chemical form, so that the drug may be dissolved, entrapped or encapsulated within the polymer matrix or nanoparticulate particle matrix. The basic concept that we have to involve that go for the why we have to need for that nanoparticles like the drug carriers. So it is selective and effective localizations of pharmacological or therapeutic active moiety or drugs at the pre-selected target. So target is most important. So pre-selected target in therapeutic concentration. It provides the restrictions of its access to only to the non-targeted normal tissues and cells. So that is also, that's why that concept may be gained, because we would only focus about targeted normal tissue, targeted tissue or the cell, other cell tissues that we have to restrict that the drugs not reach to that particular cell or tissues like that, and we have to focus only to the targeted cell or tissues, and we have to reach the maximum amount of drug to the targeted area, so we get the better or optimum therapeutic response or pharmacological response from that drug or dose. Nanoparticles similar like liposomes, neosomes also mainly taken by the reticuloendothelial systems after the administration. Types that we have to see normally like similar like microparticles, microspheres. Here also that in any sustained control drug system you have to go for matrix or reservoir type system. So in that microsphere or microcapsule, similar like the nanosphere, nanocapsules are there. So nanospheres, in that the matrix type systems are there in which drug is embedded, enclosed or physically or uniformly, sorry for the nanosphere, in the matrix systems the drug is uniformly distributed throughout the polymer matrix. So that is nanosphere. In nanocapsules, maybe reservoir systems also we can call, in which the drug is embedded, encapsulated into the surrounded by the or encapsulated by the polymer membrane. So that is nano capsule. What are the advantages that we have to consider? So the reduction in the frequency of dosage form, like similar like all the sustained control, like more uniform effect that we have to achieve for the drug, reduction of drug side effect. We have to only focus for targeted drug system. So other cell organ, that also parts we have to restrict it, so reduce the side effect for that cell organ tissue, reduce the fluctuation in circulation drug level. So that's why we have to maintain the drug concentration in the plasma, so that more uniform we have to get it, avoid the hepatic first pass metabolisms. So like that, so some advantages are there for the nanoparticles. Same like advantages, some disadvantages are there for the nanoparticles. So that First of all, for all the novel delivery system, the cost for the manufacturing production parts, so that high cost for the preparation or manufacturing part, productivity more difficult to produce, reproducibility similar size, same release mechanisms. Then they reduce the ability to adjust the dose, so less flexibilities are there. Highly sophisticated instrument equipment, so technology we have to require, or for that skilled persons require for them that handling that production part, so it requires skill to manufacture. And lastly, for when we have to go for the size reduction up to the micro nano size, so stability problems are arise, so that difficult to maintain the stability of dosage form. So many factors are there, like the aggregations are there, effect of temperatures that may be changes the stability parts of the dosage form. So these are some disadvantages of the nanoparticles. The next, the ideal characteristic for the nanoparticles or nanotechnology. So it should similar like others, it is biochemically inert, non-toxic, non-immunogenic are there, should be stable for both physical and chemically for both the conditions like in vivo, in vitro. Then controllable, predictable rate drug release, like any control or sustained drug release like that. So restrict the drug distribution, restrict to the non-targeted cell, organ or tissue, give uniform distribution of drug. Drug release that should not affect the action of the drug. The preparation of delivery system should be easy. Reasonables are there. Specific therapeutic amount of drug release must be posted. That carrier must be biodegradable or readily eliminated after the excision for the elimination from the body, that not created any problems into the body part. And go for the challenge as we have to produce simple, reproducible and cost effective product. So there are the challenging parts are there. And the selection of the materials that is used for the preparation of nanoparticles. So for that, the criteria is the nature of the polymer, nature of the drug, or the physicochemical properties of drug and the polymers are there. Then what are the criteria for the size? So specific size we have to require up to like that, we have to go for 50 to 100 nanometers. So like this, the size of the nanoparticle also we have to consider. Then properties of the drug, surface characteristics of such like charge, permeability, the degree of biodegradability, biocompatibility, toxicities are there, the drug release profile that you desire, so that criteria, antigenicity of that final product. So like that, the things that you have to consider for the selection of materials for the preparation of nanoparticles. Challenges are there that already we have to know, that prevention of drug from the biological factors like degradation process, effective targeting, that is the most important part, that we have to say that targeted systems are there and we have to focus to particular targeted cell, tissue or organ, but that is very much difficult to get the effective targeting, effective concentration of drug that reach to that particular targeted cell. Then cost effectiveness. Cost also the one of the factor or challenges are there. Then product life extension means the stability, increasing the stability of shelf life of that product. So that is the challenging part for the preparation or production of the nanoparticle. In formulations of the nanoparticle like matrix or encapsulation, anyone we have to go for it. So we have to require the polymers. So that polymer that is generally used in the preparation of nanoparticles, it may be natural polymer, semi-synthetic, synthetic polymers. So in that, the most widely synthetic polymers generally used like PLGA, PLA, PCL. But nowadays, their toxic effect, unwanted effect of sometimes the polymers arise, and for the safety and efficacy purpose, nowadays the terms going on to the use of natural sources or natural polymer nowadays widely used for the researcher or the preparation of the nanoparticles. In generally, chitosan, alginate, like that the polymer generally use other than semi-synthetic cellulose base derivatives are also there. So these are the some examples that polymer that use for the preparation of nanoparticle. Then the classification types of various nanotechnology or nanoparticular drug delivery system. So like that these are the examples and they consider like silver nanoparticle, gold nanoparticles are there, dendrimers are there, fluorines are there, missile, polymeric nanoparticle, solid lipid nanoparticles are there, functionalized based nanoparticle, quantum dots, nano carbon nanotubes. So like that the nanocell. So these are the example for that magnetic based nanoparticle, nanocrystals are there, nano suspension, nano emulsion. So like there's so many types are there based on the criteria and their use, their application, their which type of drug system that we have to apply. So based on their different types are classified, the nanomedicine or nano drug delivery systems are there. Then the mode or methods for the drug delivery system. So there are so many routes are there that we have to administer the nanoparticles or nanotechnology based drug delivery systems are there. So in that, the parenteral injections most widely used, that for the targeted conventionally, the IV targeting parts are there. Then other than oral routes are there, inhalations are there, implants are there. Then topical transdermal routes are nowadays are there, nozzles are there, inhalation aerosols are there. So many various routes that we have to use for applying the nano base formulation. Common the equipment that is used for the production or preparation part of the nanoparticles. So the high speed homogenizers require ultrasonic adder, milling process are there, any mills for the sizes, then supercritical fluid technology that you have to use for the filtration parts, ultracentrifugation for the separation out of nanoparticles from the nano suspension, nano emulsion, so nano ultracentrifugation, nano filtrations also. So these are some equipment that we have to use for the production of that nanoparticle. So drug loading, so that's similar like any drug carriers like microsphere, liposome, neosome, similar like that in the nanoparticle also we have to incorporate the at the time of nanoparticle production. So during the production of nanoparticles at the time that we have to incorporate the drug, otherwise incubation method, so the adsorbent, the drug after the formation of nanoparticles, so we have to prepare the empty nanoparticles and then we have to adsorb on the surface of that empty polymeric nanoparticles, the drugs that loaded at the outer surface of that carrier, polymeric carriers, and entrap in that inside with the polymer matrix that we have to entrap the drug molecule during the process. So anyone that we have to use active loading, passive loadings are there. Drug release, so that polymer that we have to use based on their particular system dependent upon the drug release. So that the release of from the surface of the particles, diffusion, and due to the erosion. So like that three different methods are there. That combination also that use or maybe happen use for the release kinetic or the drug release mechanisms. Generally the diffusion, surface are there, erosions are there. The next, the method that is used for the preparation of nanoparticle. So in that two approaches generally widely used, top down method and other one that is bottom up approach or bottom up methods are there. In top down approach that involves that breaking down of that large piece of material, large particles into the small particles that is generated that require the nanostructure from that. In the bottom up approach, which implies assembling the single atoms and molecules into the larger nanostructures are there. So that is top down and bottom up methods are there. They further briefly classified that type of methods that you have to use for the preparation of nanoparticles. So cross-linking methods are there, heat or chemical cross-linkings are there, polymerization technique methods are there, in that emulsion, polymerization, dispersion, interfacial condensation or complexations are there, and precipitation methods are there. So solvent evaporation method, solvent displacement, salting out, like that. Here one by one that methods they are given. So amphiphilic macromolecules cross linkings are there. So in that amphiphilic macromolecules like polysaccharides, proteins, then go for the cross linking and biphasic oil in water, water in oil type of dispersion systems are there, stabilized by any chemical process, chemical cross linking, otherwise heat denaturations are there, and then find out the small nanoparticles are there. So that were given. So macromolecular cross linking in water in oil emulsion. So the example aqueous protein, surfactants are there, oil base are there, homogenization and sonication that you have to use, water in oil emulsions are there, then we have to go for the heat cross linking or chemical cross linking. Then wash with the organic solvents, centrifugation, further go for the filtration, centrifugation. Now from that we have to isolate the nanoparticles. Second, in that polymerization based method. So in that the polymers that we have to use, acrylate based polymers are there. Two different approaches that we have to adopt for the polymerization methods, so emulsion based and dispersion based. So in the emulsion based, so method in which monomer to be polarized, that is emulsified in non-solvent phase, and for the monomer it dissolves in the solvent, that is non-solvent, therefore resulting the polymer. So that is dispersion polymerizations are there. Emulsion polymer is simple, that conventional that we have to use mostly. So it can be conventional or inverse depending upon the nature of continuous phase in the emulsion, oil in water, water in oil. In that, two different mechanisms for the emulsion polymerization, micellar polymerization or homogeneous nucleation polymerizations are there. So here the diagrams they are given for that micellar nucleation and polymerization, that is homogeneous polymerization mechanisms are there. Then the dispersion polymerization, so in that method monomer instead to be go for the emulsified, that is dissolves in aqueous medium, then which act as a precipitant for the subsequent form the polymer. So here that the procedures they are given for the dispersion polymerizations are there. So acrylamide or methyl acrylate based monomer in aqueous medium. Then we have to go for any chemical cross-link, chemical initiation or radiation, gamma radiations. Give the heat to that above solution. Then oligomer aggregate and precipitations are there, and then the formation propagation of the nanosphere or nanoparticles are there. Like interfacial condensation polymerization, their procedures are given. So that polymer that you have to firstly dissolve into the volatile organic solvent, then solution pour into the non-solvent for both non-based, so for both polymer and the core phase. Polymer phase is separated as a coadsorptive phase at the oil water interface. The resultant mixtures instantly turn into milky, that owing to formation of nanocapsules like precipitate turbid, like removed under vacuum, and the size of the nanocapsules that you have to find around 30 to 300 nanometers are there by the that process. That even by that, so core phase, the drugs are the polymer phase that you have to mix, disperses, you have to form oil in water emulsifications are there, and from that we have to find out that nanosphere or nanocapsules like that. The interfacial complexation, so that aqueous polyelectrolyte solutions that you have to dissolve, reverse micelles in polar bulk phase, polar phase are there, additions of that polyelectrolytes, so that the insoluble polyelectrolyte coadsorbate at the interface. Then go for the cross-linking like chemical heat like that, so that nanoparticles dispersions are there, that polymeric nanoparticles that you do form. So that give the example water plus monomer A oil phase, high pressure homogenizers are there, emulsifications are there, and nanocapsules you have to form. Like that solvent evaporation or solvent extractions are there. So in that the aqueous phase that containing the stabilizers, and water immiscible organic solvents that containing polymer and drug, that we have to go for the emulsifications, simple conventional oil in water type of emulsion that you have to form. Then we have to remove or extract that solvent by any solvent evaporator methods are there, or you have to reduce the pressure, we apply the vacuum, or we have to go for rotaevaporator like that. So we have to remove the solvent that affect the diffusion of the solvent to the external phase, and that polymer precipitations are there. So here the process are there, that polymeric solution that we have to add slowly we have to dissolve into the aqueous solution that contain the stabilizers. Here we have to use high speed stirrer, continuously agitations are there. So drop by drop that we have to add it, we have to put into the magnetic stirrer, also heating parts with that you have to give, you have to remove the solvent, they go for the precipitation, form the spherical particle, nano size particles are there. So dispersion from preformed polymers, so that is the factors that we have to consider for that solvent evaporation, the type and the concentration of stabilizers that we have to use, speed of the homogenizers, polymer ratio, polymer drug ratio or polymer concentrations are there. So same procedures that already we have to see for the solvent evaporation, that polymer in organic solvent, drug is also in the organic solvent, that we have to add into the aqueous solution drop by drops, that aqueous solution containing stabilizer surfactant, we have to go for continuously stirring, the emulsification process are there, simple oil in water emulsion are formed, then we have to go for the evaporation of that organic solvents. So due to the precipitation parts, polymer precipitation, the particles that form, that is our polymeric nanoparticles or nanoparticles are there. Like nano precipitation, similar like solvent extraction, evaporation, so not solvent displacement. So here in that organic solvent, the diffusion and displace the external aqueous phase, precipitation of that polymer at the interface of that immiscible solvent. So interfacial deposition of that polymer, solvent that is removed, and free flowing nanoparticles that are obtained under the reduced pressure for the weather vacuum we apply for the removal of that solvent. So that is in that factors that affect the increase in the concentration of water miscible solvent that decrease the particle size for solvent diffusion. Similar like salting out, so here saturated aqueous solution of PVA and the organic solution, organic solvent like acetone, in which the polymer is dissolved, then we have to go for this emulsification, oil in water, then addition of that water to the external phase. So the diffusion of that acetone from the internal phase into the aqueous phase, and they go for the precipitation, that is salting out approaches are there. Like that, other than coexervations technique like ion exhalation, that also nowadays that is used for the preparation of nanoparticles, like ion exhalation method. In that, natural polymer chitosan most widely used for that ion exhalation. So chitosan that you would dissolve into the aqueous phase or the organic also acetic acid, in that chitosan that you would dissolve into the acetic acid solution, plus in that ion exhalation method the sodium TPP tripolyphosphate that you have to use it in the aqueous phase, stabilizers that we have to add it, then drop by drop we have to add chitosan solution into the aqueous phase that containing stabilizers, drop by drop continuously go for the agitations or high speed stirring that we have to put into the magnetic stirrer, and then we have to get the nanoparticles. Other than that, advance in supercritical fluid technology also used for the preparation of nanoparticles. Then in that, the rapid expansion of supercritical solutions methods are there, and SS methods are also there for the preparation of nanoparticles. So these are the method or techniques for the preparation of nanoparticles. And then next, the characterization of nanoparticles. So it is similar like the previous microsphere, liposome, neosomes, the carriers are there, small size carriers are there, so their evolution or characterization are similar. Like we have to here also we have to go for particle size, shape, surface area, surface morphology, size, size distribution. So we have to go for scanning electron microscopy. So SEM, TEM also there, photon correlation spectroscopy, laser diffractometry use, atomic force microscopy. So many electronic microscopic advanced method we have to use for the particle size, size distributions, theta sizes that we have to use, charge determinations, theta potential we have to find out by particles, theta sizes that we have to use for the surface, hydrophobicity, water contact angle measurements are there, chemical analysis of that surface, so mass spectroscopies are there, drug interactions with the polymers or carriers or carrier drug interactions, we have to go for the DAC, differential scanning calorimetry, then release profile, so we have to, here also we have to go for the diffusion studies also, dialysis are also there, or in vitro dissolution studies that we have to also go for it, then the drug stability or stability of the nanoparticles, so bioassay that you have to go for it, chemical analysis of the drugs are there, so that are the types that you have to go for the, then the crystalline behaviors are there, that's also you have to go for XRD, TGA or DAC are there, then surface interaction parts also, surface analysis, so FTIR are there, NMRs are there, mass are there, particle size, shape, surface area, TEM, SEMs are there, and for size distribution, particle size determination, so theta sizes are there. So these are the instrument or method that you have to use for the characterization of the nanoparticles. Then lastly, the applications of the nanoparticles. So in the pharma point of view, in the pharmaceutical field, the applications mostly targeted delivery system, so that you have to use for the cancer therapy, so that is most widely used for that part. Other than intracellular targetings are there, so for that, for the sustained control, so prolonged systemic circulation parts, to the vaccine adjuvants, parole or absorptions that we have to use, ocular delivery system for that also, DNA drug delivery, oligonucleotide deliveries are there, so similar like the other carriers like liposome, neosomes. Some similar applications are there for the nanoparticles in pharma field. Other than the pharma, the nanotechnology or nanoparticles, they have to use for most widely used for so many areas, so many fields are there, like textile industry, textile fields are there, biomedical that already, or healthcare that we have to use for the imaging, targeting parts, cancer therapy, control release, that type of things are there, food, agriculture part also nowadays, so many research are there, so many importance they are given for the nanoparticles, nanotechnology, electronics, environmental renewal, and so like that's that use of the nanotechnology, nanoparticles day to day for every field, every parts in the world. So these are the discuss about, conclude about the nanoparticles, their type, their classifications, their advantages, disadvantages, ideal characteristic of the nanoparticle, the method of preparation, characterization of the nanoparticle, and the applications of nanoparticle in the pharma field. Thank you.